Cronulla in those days was like heaven. A family of surfers. They were a band of brothers. There were no bodyboards to be seen in the water.
Initially, it was a sport for really young kids until you had kind of cool older guys doing it.
And it was a very nice atmosphere. Everyone respected each other.
The Sarge article was definitely a way to destroy bodyboarding, and they did a good job at it.
A lot of things changed after that.
I think all surfers hated bodyboarders in the early 90s.
You're not a real surfer if you don't stand up and all that sort of bullshit.
And then the next thing you know, they're into each other.
There was too many, like, surfers that were haters, and they just buried bodyboarding.
This is where the Skid Kids didn't back down.
The Skid Kids were this wild bunch of dudes from Cronulla.
Young, loose, fluoro.
They exemplified everything, you know, surfing was not.
Definitely doing their own thing and how they wanted to do it. And, you know, there's something pure in that.
The association was trying to promote this clean-cut image, and we hated it.
Their respect was hard to beat.
They were just loose and raw and what the sport needed.
They gave it an identity, they gave it a culture.
At the time, you know, it went from being this really dorky little athletic style sport, and then it kind of grew and grew and grew and grew, and then it just collapsed.
There's a ton of brands that were in bodyboarding and just disappeared overnight. And the Skid Kids, they kept going.
Skid Kids innovated a whole new way of surfing and a whole new realm of bodyboarding.
They embodied that spirit of freedom, and they weren't afraid of the ramifications of what they did.
I made it out alive, that's the main thing.